a habit. Aristotle, Greek philosopher. Sachin Tendulkar.
All the way for six, Sachin Tendulkar.
As we all know, the Global Indian International School is one of the leading schools in Singapore. By virtue of being a school, we all know we are in K-12 education. So I thought I would take this opportunity to highlight to you, beyond schools, what we have been contributing to our society in general. This year is the 10th anniversary of the Global Schools Foundation in Singapore, an organization that found its roots not very far up from here at Mount Sophia, with just 48 students, and now evolved into a conglomerate and to a network of 20 schools across 7 countries, which is indeed a pride for us that this is a Singapore-based institution which has made its inroads into various regional countries. At the honor of a former president of India, Dr. Abdul Kalam, to join us for the inaugural simple ceremony that we had for inaugurating 10th year anniversary celebrations. Global Indian International School is known by its Indian identity in Singapore, but across the world, it is a multinational, multicultural organization which has attracted students from over 52 nationalities and still growing. As we speak, Malaysia, our schools are catering to 50% Malaysian citizens, and this is not by our design but by choice of the Malaysians. And very recently, Malaysia has opened up the educational limits to 100%, which means that we can have more students in Malaysia. In Japan, very interestingly, 48% of our students are ethnic Japanese students. And that really gives us great pleasure because these Japanese students are actually coming for an Indian curriculum. Similarly, our countries, our schools in other countries have been expanding. And the diversity of the education is reflected from students coming from multiple ethnicities. These are the various recognitions we have got for two of our campuses. The Queenstown campus, which has got 3 awards. The Ballester campus has got 2 international awards. When we say these educational excellence awards, these are basically assessments done by the national agencies to their criteria and requirements. And they use independent assessors to actually do site visits to your school, verify the facts that you presented as part of your applications for educational excellence. So we are basically benchmarking our schools against some of the best schools in the world. So not only with the schools in Singapore, but also in the region and also in the world. So these are benchmark situations where we are very proud that we've done extremely well so far and we continue to do so. A quick glimpse of some of the new projects that we are going to be helped by IFC in our expansion. The Pune campus, we have a brand new campus in Pune for 3,000 students, which has started last year. The Surat campus has started again this year, which is a completely brand new campus for us. This is a campus that we started near Noida, near Delhi this year. Again, IFC is going to be very helpful in providing us the growth capital needed here. We will have more discussions about IFC, and may I request my colleague, Mr. Vipul, to also join us and share a few words about today's signing ceremony.
Thank you very much, Atul, for those wonderful remarks, and indeed, I think you, Kostub, and Rajiv, and all members of the GIIS family, and now IFC as a financier, we are all very proud of what you've achieved. So congratulations on everything that you've achieved in 10 years. It's a long time, but at the same time, when you think of infrastructure, social sectors, not very long at all. So the achievements are quite fantastic. From my perspective, I'm delighted to be here today to sign the agreements and signal the strength of our relationship. For IFC, it's a very significant event as well because as some of the members of the press may know that IFC has an office in Singapore for about a year now. And this is also our first investment in Singapore-based education provider, and also since the first investment since the office opened. So it's quite a landmark from our perspective. And you can imagine for IFC, which is a member of the World Bank Group, how important investment in social sectors is. And to focus that even further, let me just mention that Mr. Jim Yong Kim just took over as president of the World Bank starting July 2, it was a Monday, July 1. And he had a meeting with the staff, and his own background, he's a double doctor, a physician and an anthropologist and an educationist. He was president of Dartmouth College. And I would say that I took away two things from what he told us. One is he said that health and education are perhaps the most cherished sectors serving the most basic human needs. And despite everything that goes into it, and all the competence that we have, he says the last mile delivery is something that still needs improvement. And he actually felt that the private sector does a better job in the delivery of the social sectors. So clearly going forward, he sees the role for IFC as the private sector investment arm of the World Bank to push more in the social sectors. And so again, I'm delighted that we are doing this. Now, GIIS, as you learned from Akul's remarks, is a high quality institution, but at the same time, an institution that provides very affordable education for what it does. And for us as IFC, the footprint is very important, that this is a Singapore-based education provider, but which is then exporting the knowledge and the standards to other emerging markets like India, Vietnam, Indonesia. I want to thank everybody for bringing us here, and we look forward to doing more with GIIS over the years. This is only the beginning of our partnership, really. So I'm sure there'll be a lot of more opportunities, and wishing GIIS much success. Thank you very much.
Your first investment out of the Singapore office is in private education. Is this a trend that you're likely to follow, to invest more in private education, or are you also looking at other social sectors within Asia itself? Why do you choose to partner a private education provider for this role, and you know, will you also consider partnering civil society groups and NGOs in the future as well for the education sector?
IFC is the private sector investment arm of the World Bank Group, so everything that the IFC finances is for the private sector with a profit motivation, but meaning meeting development objectives. So for example, in the context of education, we like to see our projects to be inclusive, more